Kurt Mertens and an engraver at work on a die for a new spoon. Mertens' artisans still use centuries-old methods to make his company's products. One wrong stroke can wipe out 5 days of work. It's painstaking, but it pays.
This pattern is very popular in the Middle East, one of our most important markets. People love the elaborate decoration and the Made in Germany label.
The Karl Mertens Cutlery Company still makes all of its products in Germany. Most of the company's rivals, including the German ones, have moved their production to Asia, where costs are much lower. But Mertens refuses to give up on traditional craftsmanship and the company's old plant. The factory in Solingen produces about 500,000 pieces of cutlery a year. Mertens and his 83-year-old mother have gone through some tough times over the years. His grandfather, Karl Mertens, founded the company after World War I and started with pocket knives. His father added table cutlery to the company's product line, and business boomed. Karl Mertens tableware became top sellers at New York department stores like Bloomingdale's and Macy's. Then he died suddenly while on a business trip in the late 1970s.
That was a critical moment when my husband didn't come back alive. That was difficult for me and for my son, who was still very young and planning to study medicine. But then he stayed with the company. It was difficult at first to find customers. But in business, you always have ups and downs.
Kurt Mertens has one son. He'll soon begin studying economics. Both hope that one day he'll take over management of the company. New and distinctive designs are an important part of Mertens' strategy for keeping his company ahead of the competition. This set will hit the market in 2011. He brings out 5 new models every year, with the aim of keeping customers interested with a constant stream of surprising new ideas.
It's very important for us to create innovative products, products like these. That gives our product line something special. It's what Mertens stands for, and we need to stay as far ahead of our competitors as possible. Because when we bring out something new, we know that even competitors may follow with something similar very quickly. That's the way it is in a branch where design is important.
The Mertens Company's cutlery has even made it into the German Knife Museum in Solingen. On display are the first modern models, made in 1959. Mertens often sends his designers to the museum to find inspiration. Even in the Middle Ages, people appreciated unusual or eccentric designs. And the museum contains many exhibits that can surprise visitors interested in design.
We have one ancient spoon in our collection, for instance, that looks absolutely modern. Totally smooth, a clear shape, an attractive and functional form that you can't really improve on. It's more than 2,000 years old.
It also has an uncanny resemblance to one of the Mertens Company's best sellers. At the company's retail outlet, it quickly becomes clear that exclusive design made in Germany has its price. A salad serving set for 50 euros has to have something that sets it apart and makes it worth a premium.
It's something that not everyone has.
Experience has shown that 9 out of 10 times customers like the company's new designs. Kurt Mertens' sense for what customers want seems likely to assure the company a secure future.